This is the Ciliz Brook, a small stream which used to be an artery of biodiversity in the landscape, bringing much needed water to humans and wildlife alike as it meandered through the forests and fields. But over time, it has become a destroyed and beaten up little river, polluted by this huge pile of trash and crisscrossed by human infrastructure, which has led to it actually being stuck in a dead end now. Here behind me, you can see the problem. This is supposed to be a running brook, full of life. But instead, we have this messy, stagnant pool that is not really good for anything. And this here is a field full of invasive species, which is conveniently located at the end of this river. I think you can see where we're going with this. So our plan is simple. We want to restore the flow of this river by giving it an endpoint. You know, by giving the water a way out through the digging of a new channel. And then we want to direct all that water into this tiny forest island here, and also this field, so that we flood an area of about 33 hectares, and in the process, create an extremely rare ecosystem. Wet sedge meadows. If you hadn't noticed already, here at Mossy Earth, we really love flooding stuff. That is actually because this is our second project of this type. You see, last year we began work on flooding a forest, and the early results have been absolutely incredible. Plants and trees are thriving, endangered wildlife has returned, and overall biodiversity is booming. So naturally, when our ambitious Slovak friends at BROZ came up with this new idea, we jumped at the opportunity to fund this work, because we know that this is exactly the kind of project that our community wants to fund. There is a lot to talk about here. There is the polluted river, the small forest island with a pond, and of course the field, and what will happen to it that is so special for biodiversity. While reading through the comments in recent project videos, I noticed that many of you were asking for more regular and incremental project updates. And we are of course listening to this feedback. So our goal with this video is to be the first in a series for you to follow along as we go through the process of rewilding the area. And the best way to do so is of course to subscribe to our channel here on YouTube. I know that all of you love our videos, but many of you aren't actually subscribed to our channel and might be missing out on future updates. So if you hit the subscribe button and then click the little notification bell next to it, YouTube will let you know each time a new update comes out. And this ultimately also gives YouTube a positive signal, which helps us reach more people, thus allowing us to find more members and fund even bigger projects. So in this first video, I want to give you an overview of what we are planning to do. And of course, also give you a tour of the project area and an existing sedge wet meadow that is a great example of what we are trying to achieve. Now, let's start with the origin of the problem, the little Ciliz Brook. So this road here is the actual problem. The brook behind me in this forest, it comes up against the road and then it simply gets stuck and the water is sort of backlogged and it gets stagnant.
Using a drone, I can show you the types of obstacles this creek faces. And here at the end, you can see clearly where it gets stuck. Now, the full story of this stream is one that I want to explore in depth in an upcoming video, because it is really interesting. But right now, I think you need to know two things about it. How it is polluted in some areas, but clearly still suitable for wildlife, and that it has been heavily modified by roads, agricultural channels, and fields, to the point where certain parts of it have been dry for years. This is something that BROZ has been fixing up for a while now, with dozens of interventions, such as this one, where they've tunneled the stream under an existing agricultural channel to allow it to continue running along its old course, and thus bringing water to places where it's been gone for a really long time now. And of course, they've also been dealing with the obvious problem of the huge trash pile. And they're doing so in a really cool way, by engaging the local community in volunteer days to come and clean up this mess. I think it's really cool, and we were able to attend one of these days and to see all these people from different backgrounds and different walks of life come together to try and repair something is really inspiring. All of this to say that our intervention at the end of the Ciliz Brook is just the final effort, part of a long-term work that BROZ has undertaken. But as I said, that is a story for a future video. Now let's look at the area we are flooding. Our channel will be dug from here to here. And the first area it will bring water to is this small forest island surrounded by agricultural fields. It is a bit deeper than the surrounding area and an ideal place for newts and toads to reproduce in the shallower depths. I think this would be a worthwhile project on its own, so it's really cool to have it as a bit of a bonus outcome for this bigger intervention. So now I'm trying to reach the area where the amphibian pond will be. I mean, this whole part here will be flooded, but I'm trying to look for the exact
place where most of the water will hopefully accumulate and provide this important habitat. As you can see here, there's quite a bit of vegetation in the way, but once we get to the center, yeah, there's already some water accumulating here. So Jakub and Mishka did not pick this spot at random, of course. They looked at some really detailed maps to understand that this would be a good spot. But it's nice to see that there's already some water here, because it means once we divert the river this way, it will become a really nice wetland. We're also looking at the idea of blocking this area here off to fish, so that the Danube crested newt and the European fire-bellied toads populations get a chance to reproduce so that they can grow in number. Because the fish are generally doing quite okay in this region, but these amphibians are struggling a bit more. And I know that it is like picking favorites, essentially, and that it isn't rewilding in its purest form, but we have to mix the idea of conserving species and trying to give back space to nature. And I think this is a good compromise. From here, our channel will continue towards the field, passing under this small road, and finally opening up into this wide area.
This is it. This is the field we're going to flood, and I must say it's quite strange because it's such a normal agricultural field. But it's really exciting to think that that over there is going to become a wetland.
But as you get closer, you can see that this field is not in an ideal state.
This field here might look really pleasant to the untrained eye, and it is enjoyable to sit here, of course, but it's actually covered in invasive species, such as this plant right here next to me, which is a type of solidago species. So our project will aim to do two things in one go. It'll aim to get rid of the invasives because they don't like water, and it will bring back the rare sedge meadows wet habitat. And this is something that is very rare with one intervention, that you can essentially get rid of an invasive species that is not good for the native biodiversity and bring back something which is so rare and precious, a natural habitat that is under pressure.
The area we are flooding is around 33 hectares in size. And for you imperial people out there, that is around 81 acres, 46 normal football fields, or 61 American football fields. So you can pick whichever metric works best for you. And from up high, you can really see the scale of what we are working with. It's actually pretty epic to imagine how our small intervention will transform this whole area for the better. Well, when I say for the better, I haven't really told you much to back this up, so let's look at the benefits of this project. In terms of the species that will benefit from this project, I already mentioned the European fire-bellied toad and the Danube-crested newt, which we hope will benefit from the amphibian pond in the small forest islands. And then in the main area, we hope to support fish, such as the Amur bitterling, and mammals, such as the Pannonian root vole, various shrews, and also the Eurasian otter. Now, of course, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of other species, including birds, of course, that will benefit from this. But this should provide you with an overview of the species that we are targeting, and also how broad the benefits really are. Then, at a landscape level, the wetland will also have the added benefit that it will effectively create a shelter for wildlife, in what is essentially a very agricultural landscape. And creating these small refuge areas is really key to maintaining biodiversity in these regions in the long run. In terms of a timeline for the work, we hope to start in spring or summer, depending on how fast the licenses come through. Then we hope to have it completed by the fall, so it can start flooding then. And hopefully in 1 year, we can see the first significant results already. So, Duart from the future here, as we were going through our edit, we actually noticed that we were missing an important bit of information, which is of course what this project is going to cost. So we've budgeted around 80,000 euros to complete the full project, including the channels under the road and all kind of safety measures. And with this, as you know, we are planning to achieve around 40 hectares of these amazing wetlands. So I think that's really good bang for your buck. And if you're wondering where all that money is coming from, well, the answer is our community, our members, people who essentially watch our videos and decide to contribute small amounts every month to help us fund these projects. So yeah, just a small reminder that that's how we fund this stuff. It's not some big corporation giving us loads of cash to do this. We do this with you, our members. So if you'd like to contribute to something like this, then yeah, be sure to check out the link in the description and in the pinned comments down below. Now, back to the rest of the video. And to better show you what this might look like in the future, we visited an area that has been undergoing restoration for some years now. Right now, I'm in Ciliz, which is another property managed by our partners BROZ along the Ciliz brook.
And this area, they've been doing interventions since 2016 to help restore the flooding regime and also help rid it of invasive species so that essentially you can bring back a proper wetland ecosystem. And it's a great example of what we would like to do with our area further downstream. So what's really great to see is the return of the native species. So in this piece of wetland that you can see right here, we have the all-important carex species that are essential for the Pannonian root vole. And these reeds here that you can see, they're different kinds of tipa species, which are also really important for this habitat. And the way this works is that essentially, by having water here, it helps reduce the suitable habitat for the invasive solidago species. But in order to accelerate this process, BROZ also has to do these cuttings here, which might seem a bit counterintuitive. But what they do is they come in and they cut the whole area, and when it floods again, the solidago species do not return. Okay, so in case you were confused by my explanation, please let me give it another try from up here. You start with an area that is dry and overrun by non-native invasives, like our area is. Then you restore the water regime and start doing some cutting in strips. Each year, as you cut a different strip, you slowly weed out the invasives through a mix of the cutting itself and the excess water from the new flooding regime. While on the other hand, the native wetland species come back stronger and stronger each year. Then of course, further down the line, there is a point where all of this is left alone. But for now, it's a really effective way of accelerating the transformation of the area. And there is proof that this is working really well. Here in these two shots, you can see the light green solidago species, and they've been reduced quite a bit in just 1 year of doing this practice. What I think is really exciting about this project is also the speed at which nature can come back. I mean, this wetland, 4 or 5 years ago, looked completely different. There was no water, it was full of invasive species, and now it's thriving. It's provided important habitat for a wide variety of wetland species. So I really hope that our area can follow suit and do exactly what happened here. And if you think this kind of work is worth supporting, then please consider heading over to mossy.earth to learn more about becoming a member and supporting a lot of rewilding projects just like this one here. Until next time. Cheers!